Hello there, my name is Nina Shaban and welcome to this special broadcast where we'll be having a sit down with the chief executive of the Kenya Deposit Insurance Corporation, that is Madam Helen Chepkwony. And of course, the conversation is on deposit insurance and bank resolution, with the theme being fortifying Kenya's financial stability and empowering depositors. Thank you so much for having us. A beautiful office, I must say.
Thank you very much, Nina, for coming to our office.
All right. So it's only fine if I start with a background check. It's going to be a year in May 2024 since you started your journey as the chief executive right here at KDIC. Maybe you can shed some light on how the journey has been thus far.
Thank you very much. The journey has been good since I joined KDIC. We've had several things that have gone for us as an institution. We've been able to have what we call differential premium done for our institutions. By that, I mean that we've been able to have banks review how we charge them premiums based on their risk. That's one of the things I can mention that has happened. Over this period as well, we've been able to have so many of our policies approved. I consider that as a feather on our side, and thanks to the board for their approvals of the same. And over at the same time, we've also won awards. We won the FIRE Awards for the state corporations. We also won the Innovations Award during this time as financial sector institution as well.
All right.
So we're happy.
Okay, and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank
and happy anniversary once the 1 year hits, in case you and I do not get to meet. Now, what would you say is the core mandate of the KDIC, especially when it comes to its role in the socio-economic agenda?
Okay, so KDIC was set up under what we call the KDI Act of 2012. And basically, it was set up to provide deposit insurance. The government set it up to provide deposit insurance for the depositors of all the banks and microfinance institutions. And this was done to encourage people to put their money or to save their money in those regulated banks. And our other mandate was also to provide prompt resolution, so that in the unlikely event of a bank failure, then the KDIC is to come in to support or to bring about a resolution, an efficient way of resolving that bank that has failed, so that it doesn't affect the whole economy. Because when a bank fails, it causes disruptions to businesses and to the whole economy. So our job is to ensure that that is streamlined, and that people are able to do their business and get their deposits as and when they need them. So the other job, or the other mandate that we have, is to undertake some risk management, where we undertake early intervention on these banks. So we monitor these institutions, and in case we see some likely where they are likely to have a problem, then we kind of intervene. We have discussions with them to see ways of having to prevent them from actually failing and coming to liquidation. Yes.
Okay, so we have a deposit insurance and bank resolution. Yes. Okay, I want us to take one, or rather each individually, and delve in deeper, starting with the now deposit insurance, which you've already given just a slight information on.
Okay, so on the mandate of deposit insurance, what we do in that mandate is we levy premiums on the commercial banks. We don't levy on depositors. It's on the banks that are our member institutions, where they pay premiums. And in that premium, we are able to build a fund. we are able to build a fund, and that money is used and invested to grow that fund, so that in case of unlikely event of a bank failure, then we as KDIC pay protected deposits. So the customer is assured that if in case of a likely event of a failure of their bank where they put their money, then they can come to KDIC and they will be paid up to the level of our protected deposit. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now bank and resolution.
Yes. Now in bank resolution, this occurs once KDIC has been appointed. So the central bank, once they have seen the solvency of an a bank is not okay, then they can make they can appoint KDIC as the liquidator or the receiver of that bank. So when that happens, now we start the process of this resolution, either through receivership, we receive, liquidate, and at the end of it, wind up that institution. So the process starts from the appointment of KDIC during receivership. During receivership, it's where the institution could still be operating. We are still trying to analyze how their performance and whether it can actually go back to life and operate in business, in their business. But if at that time it is assessed that they are not able to get back to business and can cause disruption, then KDIC is then again appointed as a liquidator. Mm-hmm. So when we are appointed as a liquidator, the process of now recovering or asset tracing and recovering from that bank, because you know when a bank is in operation, it has both the depositors and the debtors,
yes,
and the creditors of that institution. So at that time when we are appointed liquidator, we are able to recover from the debtor so that we can be able to pay the depositors. Yes. First of all, the protected deposits we'll have done at the beginning. Once we are appointed as a liquidator, then we go ahead and make the protected deposits. Currently, it's around 500,000 Kenya shillings. So that is made first. And with that 500,000, usually we cover almost 99% of all the account holders. Mm-hmm. Therefore, after that, now we've set on the recovery process, and whatever is recovered, we declare what we call dividends, of which now the depositors are paid accordingly.
Okay, so two questions right there. I'm sorry for cutting you short, Madam CEO. One, I'd like to know, how long does this process take until now the depositors actually get to see us sent back? And two, there was an issue on the capping of 500,000 shillings. Maybe you can also shed some light on that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you've asked on how long. By law, we under the KDI Act, we are expected to pay the depositor within 30 days. But more often than not, we pay maybe within the first 7 days. The only issue is with some of the institutions that failed recently, we had problems because of legal tussles and everything that prevented us from making those payments. But generally, we are expected to make those payments. And since the money that is coming from KDIC, not from the institution, we do not expect that institution to have money mm-hmm. by the time it is being mm-hmm. closed. So KDIC makes those payments. So we are expected to make within 30 days.
Okay.
Yes. And you have asked the second question about the capping of the 500. So over time, KDIC reviews on the coverage, what the 500, how much we cover. And it is informed by the level of deposits in the country, how much on average the common person holds their deposits. And also, we try to take care of what we call a moral hazard, a situation where if we were to cover all the deposits, then these banks or microfinance banks might be reckless in their lending because they know there's a KDIC that will pay
true.
Everyone.
Yeah,
so
true.
There's a certain element that is left for the market forces mm-hmm. to determine. And therefore, during the last review, they saw it fit that 500,000 would cover many of our depositors, and they also look at other variables like the state of our economy. They look at the GDP per capita and all those aspects, and therefore with that 500,000 we are able to cover 99% of all our account holders.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. With whatever we've just discussed, with that said, what would you say is the essentiality of deposit insurance, considering the history of the saving culture in Kenya? We have numerous bank failures.
Yes. So KDIC was set up essentially to enhance public confidence in Kenya's financial system. Our job is to actually protect the depositors. And the moment the depositors are actually assured that their money is protected by KDIC, then that enhances their confidence to put their money in the banking sector. And that, in general, as you are aware, that savings can lead to investments and the general economic development of our country.
True.
So our job is actually to bring that assurance to the public that we come here with this fund that is able to meet your obligations and pay you in the unlikely event of that bank failure.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And what would you say is the current situation of the financial institutions, or not even situation, but the current affairs of the financial institutions that you have under your wing, under KDIC?
I can say that we currently have 52 institutions that are our members, and they are all sound. Yes, and we monitor them, and the primary regulator is the Central Bank of Kenya, and we have no cause to worry.
All right, so Madam CEO, you've talked to us about the 52 institutions under your wing. Are these the ones that are existing? Maybe you need to clarify.
Yes, indeed. We currently have 52 member institutions. Those are the commercial banks and the microfinance banks that are regulated by the Central Bank of Kenya. And they are the ones that the depositing public deposit their money countrywide in the country. So those are our members who pay the premiums. We also, under our management here, we have 19 institutions that failed over a period of time. We have some that failed in 1993 to the latest that failed in 2016, that was Imperial Bank. So with those 19 institutions, those are the ones that are at various stages of resolution towards winding them up.
Could you please, let's delve into the different challenges that the organization has faced, and how exactly have they been tackled?
Okay. In terms of challenges, I would mention that one of them is the low public awareness. Very few people know of our existence as an organization, and that's why we try as much as possible to engage several stakeholders to make people aware that we exist, because we've seen situations when a bank fails, people just assume that, oh, they have lost their money, and they go home. They don't come and claim their deposits from us. And that has been a low public awareness about our existence or our mandate has been one of the challenges.
Mm-hmm.
The other one is long litigation periods that we take. Because of what we call the bank resolutions that we undertake, most of the times it involves the court system, where now we want to seize an asset, like some a security that you had given as a loan. I mean, when you are given a loan, most people tend to go to court and have it protected, so that we are not able to either sell because they have not paid their loans. You get it? So, and the court process sometimes takes so long, and therefore we're not able to realize the monies which we are supposed to pay the depositor. Yes, I think I can just mention those two.
Those are the two.
That, yes.
And so with that said, what policies are you hoping that would be put in place to ensure a seamless working environment, and that every move that you make is not affected, like things like the litigation matters.
Yes. On the litigation matter, we have adopted what we call the alternative dispute resolution,
mm-hmm.
where we are encouraging most of our debtors who are currently in court or even who have not gone to court to come to us and give us proposals on how they intend to pay their debts, so that we do not have to go through the court system. And if the proposals are okay, then we are able to amicably agree, and we can withdraw the matter from courts, and it is settled. And we find that an easier way of actually getting the debtors to pay, and so that we can pay our ultimate depositor. We also looking at other ways on the challenge of public awareness. We are looking out for partners and other stakeholders, so that we put it out there about our mandate, so that the public gets to know about our mandate, and that there is an institution that was set up by the government to ensure that the safety of their deposits.
And let's also just touch on the future strategic plans.
Yes. So our focus right now as KDIC is our strategic focus is mainly on continuing on the deposit insurance and building our fund to be able to sustain in the unlikely event of a failure, and also on the intervention measures that we undertake. So there are four key pillars in our strategic plan in this 2023-2028, that will be continuous on the deposit insurance. On risk management, we'll still continue to enhance our risk management frameworks. The third one is on the bank resolution. This is our core mandate. It will still continue. And then in that bank resolution also, we are also enhancing on efforts to wind up as many of the institutions as possible. And then the fourth one is on the institutional capacity building. We need to build capacity within our institution to be able to manage all these areas that are under our mandate.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. So as we wind up, Madam CEO, maybe you can tell us, is there anything that you'd like to put out there?
Yes, I would like to tell the public that they should take advantage of the deposit insurance that we give as KDIC, and deposit their money in regulated banks, because as they do that, they are able to support the economy in its growth. Because once you put your deposits there, then others are able to borrow, and that's how economic transformation takes place in the country. Mm-hmm. I would also like to mention that we are currently making payments for some of the institutions that failed a little while ago. We are currently paying for Thabiti Finance in liquidation, Trade Bank in liquidation, as well as Daima Bank in liquidation. So that those depositors who had their monies in those institutions can lodge their claims with us or across the country to any central bank branch, so that we can actually make payments to them.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, thank you very much. I'd like us to just go back on, you've said Thabiti?
Thabiti Finance.
Thabiti Finance.
Trade Bank.
Trade Bank.
And Daima.
And Daima Bank.
And we are also paying protected deposits for Imperial Bank.
Unprotected deposits for Imperial Bank.
In liquidation, yes.
All right.
Yes.
Well, thank you very much, Madam CEO. We appreciate you having us. Well, that's it for this particular special broadcast. We're having a sit down with Helen Chapkwony, who is the Chief Executive Officer of the Kenya Depositors Insurance Corporation. My name is Nina Shaban. Until next time.
Thank you very much.
About 13 years ago, Timothy Kiplagat was a hearts boy and an alcohol addict who would spend most of his time in the drinking dens whenever he was not tending to his employer's livestock. Fast forward to 2024, and Kiplagat is an elite athlete and currently ranked as the second fastest marathon of the year. This is the story of Timothy Kiplagat Rono's transformation and how the loss of his close friend and training partner, world marathon record holder, the late Kelvin Kiptum, just a few weeks to his race, nearly broke him. My name is Steve Keter, and this is 12 Minutes. Early March, Timothy Kiplagat clocked 2 hours, 2 minutes and 55 seconds to finish second behind Benson Kipruto at the Tokyo Marathon. It was his major marathon debut, and it turned out to be the best race of his career so far.
Tokyo ilikuwa my first major marathon. So kidogo nilikuwa na tension, ukiona majina kubwa kubwa kama kina Kipchoge. So vile niliona Kipchoge amechechemea kwa 17k. So mimi nilikuwa nafikiria tu Kipchoge maybe ni hesabu tu amepanga a reduce kidogo alafu tena anze kupick. So kwenda nilikuwa naenda huko mbele nilikuwa naenda tu nikijua nyuma kuna simba. Na kumbe tu ilikuwa maybe siku hiyo mwili yake haikurespond mzuri. Kufika mahali nikasikia mguu. Imaso pull ilistuka kidogo. That's why nika reduce pace ndio Benson akafunga. Kufika 37 nilikuwa najaribu kama naweza enda. Nikaona hiyo muscle pull itaniangusha. That's why nilikuwa najaribu kutoroka ikakata. Namba 3 alikuwa mbali kidogo, nasema ningemaintain hii pace yangu tu. I think ilikuwa 258 259 za ama mpaka 300. Nasema nikimaintain na Yesu akafunga. Kapata nikakimbia hapa same pace. Hata hiyo ndio nilifurahia, hata numbers sijafurahia. Nimefurahia kukimbia personal pace. Nilikuwa na 2350. Nikatramosha kwa 2255. Almost 1 minute.
Kulingana na ile muda ama zoezi ambayo tumefanya na vile mimi nilikuwa nimeona, nilikuwa najua kwamba atakimbia. Ni ile tu ya kwamba ilikuwa ni first major marathon, na unajua ya kwamba wale ambao walikuwa nakimbia nao sometimes lazima ukuwe na tension.
Kiplagat's rise in the full marathon has been steady, progressing one race at a time.
Hii imekuwa marathon yangu ya saba. Nilianza marathon kukimbia marathon 2021. My first marathon nilienda Endoven. Endoven marathon nikakimbia 27 early. Ilikuwa position 3. Ilikuwa mwezi wa 11 time after two corona, but ilikuwa bado ni mkubaya kabisa. 2022 mwezi wa 5 nikaenda nikakimbia Barcelona marathon, nikakimbia also nikarudia 27, but ilikuwa 2723. Nikakuja mwezi wa 9 nikaenda Melbourne. Hiyo nilikimbia 2:09, but nilikimbia course record yenye ilikuwa imekaa for 9 years. So ilikuwa nikuja nifunge season na hiyo race. So kufika kambi tukaongea na coach, nikaambia kwa sasa kuliko nifunge season mapema, si kampuni wanganipea hata kama ni kupesa. Akaniambia kwa kidogo, akaongea na dosi, kaambiwa umeconfirmiwa una pesa Abu Dhabi.
He was assigned to pace the Abu Dhabi marathon until the 30 kilometers mark. However, midway through the race, he was asked to finish the entire 42 kilometers race.
Akaniambia akona mtu amerespond hiyo pesa yako. Watu wako 1 kilometer away. So what is there tafuta chunga time yako mbele. Na hapo tena nikakimbia PP yangu 2:05:20. Nikapata chance ya kukimbia kupewa Rotterdam. Rotterdam hapo sasa nikakimbia tena PP yenye nilikimbia, nilikuwa na 2:03:50. After that, I got World Championship. World Championship, nilikimbia 211 number 14 of which siko natarajia hiyo lakini tulifika huko weather ikakuwa mbaya kabisa after world championship sasa ndio ilikuwa last year mwezi wa 8 ndio nime relax tu mpaka nilienda December 31st kuna 15 ka nilipewa na kampuni Brazil nika win for the 15 kilometers ilikuwa part ya kujitarisha kwa Tokyo juu nilikuwa nimeconfirmiwa Tokyo hapo December nilikuwa nimeconfirmiwa naenda Tokyo so kwenda 15 ka ilikuwa part of kujitayarisha kwa Tokyo.
The fact that he is considered one of the country's top elite marathoners has yet to sink in. Kiplagat credits his success to his relative Nahashon Kibon, an athletics coach who saw his potential.
Kwanza kwangu kukimbia kwangu ni wenye ilianza ni fani sana. Juzi nilikuwa najiuliza kumbe kila kitu tu inawezekana ukiwa na imani. Kwa na imani everything is possible. Mimi nilikuwa nakimbia nikiwa shule. Primary sana. High school sikusema nilikimbia sana kwa high school hapo niliingia high school alafu challenges zikatokea sikuendelea tena. Niliingia form 1 form 2. When I remember hapo 2011 maisha nilikuwa naishi naye tu kwa ile tu ya kusema tu upate mahali ya kulala kesho uamke kama umepata kazi ama hujapata utafuta ya kukula so story yenye ilikuwa ni tu ni kukunywa tu kunywa sasa mabusa ya marsaf tu majanga hiyo ndio ilikuwa tu kazi mguu kama tulikuwa nakaa kwa mguu 24/7 hata jua iko waga uwezi toa nilikuwa nachungia mama fulani ng'ombe hapo Torongo. Nashona akaniambia ulifikisha wapi mazoezi nikaambia vile shule ilikwama kila kitu kikakwama so hata kukimbia hata sijui tena kukimbia niliacha kitambo sana I think ilikuwa almost 5 years akaniambia niliacha mazoezi akaniambia nataka nikusaidie nataka nikupeleke camp unasemaje
and I knew that he had a talent you know he was capable to run. If you have a good heart, maybe to help someone, then you will realize a lot of dreams in people. Yes.
He trained for several years before he got a chance to compete in local races.
Hapa Eldoret kulikuwa na races mingi, kulikuwa family bank, kulikuwa na race ya Tuskies here, na cross country hapo Ndalat. So unaenda cross country unachukuta huko number 1 something, 150, 200. Kitu ya kwanza nashanakuwa nakuuliza nakwambia muliregister watu wangapi? Muliregister watu wangapi? Naambia maybe 300. So kuko 150 umeshinda watu 150. Yeah, unafikiri kushinda watu 150 ni rahisi? Kenya. I remember race nilijaribu kabisa nilikuwa number 40. Kuna hii race ya Discovery. Hiyo Discovery sasa ndio nikapata tukangangana kwa Discovery ilikuwa 10 kilometers. Nikakuwa number 5. Ndiyo nikapata kuingia management ya Rosa. Nikapata pesa kidogo kwa hiyo number 5. So kuanzia sasa utamu sasa ya mbio sasa ikaingia sasa. Nikaenda sasa kuenda sasa nilifika mahali nikaambia Mungu nisaidie nikienda race kaja nisipite number 10 juu kuanzia number 10 ndio analipa. 2018 sasa ndio nikapata sasa nini ya kwenda Europe sasa. Nilikimbia ma 10K mingi hapo. Ma half marathon.
Kiplagat had contemplated dropping out of the Tokyo race. This is after he lost his close friend and training partner, the world marathon record holder Kelvin Kiptum, just a few weeks to the race. Amid sobs, he painfully narrates the bond they shared as friends.
Akitoka hapa alikuwa anasema kwamba mimi naenda kufanya ile yangu pamoja na Kevin hiyo ndio alikuwa amesema kwamba naenda kufanya
story ya Kiptum uchungu lakini toto tukatrena Kiptum ara akiendanga hiyo Valencia
first marathon yake ya kwanza tulikuwa tunasaidiana kwa mazoezi. Akienda London tulikuwa tunasaidiana kwa mazoezi. Kiptum vile list ya World Championship ilitokea. Kiptum akaniambia nimeona list imetoka. Na umewekwa reserve. First reserve number 4. Kiptum akaniambia Timo ni kama mimi sitaenda World Championship. So in case nitakupea nafasi yangu. Akaniambia sasa Timo kitu yenyewe iko sasa. Kumbe hii World Cup kukimbia ni rahisi sana. Si ngumu. So akaniambia wacha mimi niende Chicago. Wacha Mungu anisaidie niende Chicago niende ningangane huko. Matokeo yanatokea tutakubali. Kuenda World Championship. Kimbie mzuri na kutakia kila heri. Mpaka jioni tukikimbia kesho World Championship. Kitumza sana nipikia Timo ngangana. Tunakuona Timo kasi sana ngangana. Kaambia sawa sitawaangusha.
He believed Kiptum was poised to become the first person to run the 42 kilometers race under 2 hours in normal competition. The late marathon record holder was to compete at the Rotterdam Marathon on April 14th.
Jo, so mimi nikaambia Kiptum kama mimi nilienda Rotterdam last year. Mimi nilikimbia 2:350. Na si kwa shebi si kwa nilisumbuka sana na injury. Naambia Kiptum walai ufike hiyo Rotterdam na whether ikwe vile nilipata mimi. Hata si hiyo 159 anasema hiyo utakimbia 157. Yo niliona vinyo Kiptum alikuwa shape na nikakumbuka tu Rotterdam hiyo course ni flat. Naambia Kiptum na mimi naomba Mungu ikupate hivyo vile nilipata mimi.
Kiplagat now hopes he will get an opportunity to wear the Kenyan colors once again and represent the country at the Paris Olympics set for this summer.
In case wanipate chance, nitafurahi kwenda Olympics.